Hi, my name is Marie-Pierre. In this first video tutorial, I will show you the central functionality of cortical.io's Retina, the Compare API. This function makes it very simple to measure the closeness of text snippets. My colleague Neil is with me to give us more details. Hi, Neil.
Hi, Marie-Pierre.
Neil, before we begin, can you tell us more about the applications where we can use the Compare API?
Cortical.io's Retina API can be used, for example, to build topic filters in message streams or to find documents in repositories based on their content. You can also use this feature to compare user profiles, making it possible to search for users based on their skills or interests.
Sounds great. Let's have a look at our interactive documentation at api.cortical.io. Select the compare function and open the compare field. Basically, you can compare any text and any terms. You just need to follow the syntax as shown in the implementation notes. Let's use this example and compare the term Pablo Picasso with the text about Gustav Klimt. We paste it in the body field. Neil, is there any limitation regarding the text length?
No, there's no limitation on text length.
Okay, so let's try it out. The first thing we see is this request URL. What is it about?
The request URL could be used to make direct REST calls. You can find more information about this in our online documentation.
Okay. Now, looking at the response body, we can see a bunch of metrics that might look frightening at first sight. Cosine similarity, Euclidean distance, Jacquard distance. What do they mean?
Well, these metrics are a quantitative description of the closeness of the two elements. For instance, the higher the cosine similarity, the closer the two elements are. Mm-hmm. As we can see, these two are relatively close. Now, if we enter a term like painter, we can maybe see a slight difference.
Okay, so let's enter painter instead of Pablo Picasso and compare it to the text about Gustav Klimt.
And as we can see, this is much closer based on the cosine similarity. If we enter a term like football, which is obviously dissimilar.
Mm-hmm. What do we get?
We see that we have a much lower value for cosine similarity, demonstrating that these two are not at all similar.
Okay.
The fingerprint approach also allows us to make a qualitative analysis using the overlap. You can look at the overlapping regions in the fingerprints to spot common topic areas.
Mm-hmm. If you want to get more information about the other metrics, you can have a look at our online documentation. Thank you, Neil.
Thank you.
So you see, cortical.io's Retina API makes it very easy to compare any kind of text. In our next video, I show you how to extract keywords using cortical.io's text API. Thank you for watching.